It's been 7 years since Black Ops 3 came out, and this is my first time playing it. Although I played Black Ops 1 and 2 in 2016 and 2017 respectively on my Xbox 360, got Black Ops 4 when it was new, and I even played Cold War mere months after it released, I thought I would play through the only game in the Black Ops saga I haven't played yet. And it's pretty good. I mean, it's nowhere near as good as Black Ops 1 or 2, and I even think Cold War is a little better. But I think it's better than 4, even if just because it has a campaign, no matter how lackluster it is. Now, this video will be in 5 sections: the intro, campaign, multiplayer, zombies, and the conclusion. Timestamps are in the description. Anyway, let's get straight into the video. Now, this is my least favorite part of the game, but at least it actually has one. Black Ops 4. Anyway, it's better than nothing, so that's something going for it. But I honestly think even Cold War's campaign, which I actually liked a fair bit besides the change in voice actors and the fact that Bell doesn't have voice lines, but that's personal preference, is significantly better. Now, I knew ahead of time that the campaign was going to be pretty lackluster, so I wasn't surprised or anything, but it just wasn't focused. I like the futuristic stuff, but the story's all over the place. I mean, with what was happening, it made sense, and I could understand what was going on enough to not be completely confused, but the story just wasn't really centralized. It was basically about learning to deal with death. My main gripe would be that none of the main characters from Black Ops 1 or 2 are in it, and are barely even mentioned, and the characters that are in it are bland and forgettable. But I guess I can appreciate the fact that the creators made a bold move in making most of the story not take place in real time, but I think they probably could have dealt with it differently and better. The multiplayer is good, but not great. I honestly think that it's my least favorite Black Ops multiplayer, but that's only because I think the others are so good. I'm not the biggest fan of wall jumping, but I commend them for trying something new. And I also don't think the maps are the strongest. I mean, they're okay. I personally like Nuketown the best, but that's always my go-to Black Ops map, so that'd be expected. I'd say this Nuketown is mid-tier. It's nowhere near as good as Black Ops 1 or 2, but I think it's better than 4. I never really fancied the Soviet backdrop of 4. And I think it's on par or just slightly worse than Cold War. The other maps are decent enough, but nothing to write home about. Now, even though the DLC maps might be a little more interesting, I'm not spending double on what I would normally consider an overpriced game at $20 for a game that's almost 7 years old on some extra maps. I couldn't realistically play online with other people on anyway. There are already so few people on that I doubt half of them have the DLC maps, but then again, they're playing a 7-year-old game, so maybe they are committed. The game modes are basically what you would expect from any Call of Duty game, and I honestly don't really have an opinion one way or another on the specialist system. It's not bad enough for me to actively criticize them for putting it in, but it's also not good enough for me to commend them for it. Since I just started playing the game, I don't have any extra specialists besides the one you start off with, and I didn't want to show you me playing against bots, so that's why I'm only playing as Ruin. Now I, as well as probably many people, think that Zombies is the best of the 3 game modes. It is the most thought out, and I honestly enjoyed my time playing it. I really like how they have Kino Der Toten on, although I don't necessarily like how they replaced the swastika, but I can always play Black Ops 1 on my Xbox 360 if I really want to see it. I also wish they remastered 5, but I know that wasn't the most popular map, and I can't expect them to remaster everything, and I do know that they remastered it on Black Ops 4, but Black Ops 4 was more of a reimagining than a remake with different characters in a similar but kind of different environment. So I still would have liked to see it on 3 with original characters, because JFK was honestly my favorite part of that map. I also like the new maps. Shadow of Evil has a nice contained story, and Origins is a good start for the main Zombies campaign. Now, should you buy Call of Duty Black Ops 3 in 2022? Possibly, if you have friends to play it with and you get it on sale. I don't think you should buy this game for a penny more than $20, not including tax, but I wouldn't call my experience a waste of time. I honestly did enjoy playing this game, and I wouldn't blame you if you think it is worth $60. I rate this game a 7.5 out of 10. I would have to rate the campaign a 6 out of 10, the multiplayer a 7 out of 10, and the zombies a 9 out of 10, but because I only spent $20 on this game and I have a friend to play it with, I round the complete experience up to a 7.5. But if I couldn't get it on sale, or if I didn't have friends to play it with, I would definitely not rate the overall experience higher than a 7. Remember to like if you like this video and subscribe if you like this sort of content. I'm still somewhat new to making YouTube videos, even though I do have an older channel, so you can check that channel out in the description if you so choose. And if enough people subscribe to that one, I might post some new original content on there. You can also check out some of my other videos here. Have a great day, and see you next time.